everyone. Today I'll read you a book. Nick Butterworth's One Snowy Night. What will be happened? Welcome to Percy's Park. Percy the park keeper works hard looking after the park and his animals' friends who live there. But Percy still likes to find time for fun and games. And of course, in Percy's park, there's always time for a story. One Snowy Night, the title of the story. It's cold in the park in winter, but Percy the park keeper doesn't mind. He put on his warm coat and his big scarf and wears two pairs of woolly socks inside his Willerton boots. Percy likes to be out in the fresh air. In the middle of the park, there was a little hut. This is where Percy lives. When it gets too cold to be outside, Percy goes into his hut when it's cozy and warm. The animals who live in the park all know Percy's hut. Every day he shares his lunch with them. One winter night, it was so cold and it began to snow. Gray snowflakes fell past the window of Percy's hut.
"Brrr," said Percy. "I think I'll need an extra blanket tonight."
He made himself some hot cocoa and got ready for bed. Suddenly, Percy heard a tapping sound. There was somebody at the door.
"No, who can that be at this time of night?" thought Percy.
He went to the door and looked out. On the step was a squirrel. It looked very cold and miserable.
"I can't get to sleep, Percy," said the squirrel.
"My bed is full of snow."
"Oh dear," said Percy. "Never mind, I've got plenty of room for two."
The squirrel snuggled down next to Percy and soon began to feel warm.
"Now, knock, knock," it was the door again. "Now, who could that be?" thought Percy.
Standing outside were two shivering rabbits. "It's freezing," said one rabbit.
We're frozen,
said the other.
"You poor things," said Percy. "Come in and warm up."
The rabbit squeezed into the bed next to Percy and the squirrel. There wasn't much room.
"Could you face the other way? Percy asked the squirrel. "Your tail is tickling my nose."
Knock, knock.
"Oh dear," said Percy. "Now there's someone else at the door."
It was the fox. He looked very cold and hungry.
"Can I come in too?" he asked.
Percy scratched his head and thought for a minute.
"Well, if you promise to behave," he said.
I promise, said the fox, and squeezed into bed next to all of the other animals. Bump! Oops! The squirrel fell out.
"Who did that?" asked the squirrel crossly.
Knock, knock, knock. "Good gracious," said Percy. "It's the door again."
This time Percy had quite surprised. There on the step was a badger, two ducks, a hedgehog, and a whole family of mice. They all wanted a bed for the night. Poor old Percy's bed. The animals pushed and shoved and rolled around the bed, but there was just not enough room for all of them. For them all. Soon the bed covers ended up in a big, tight ball. Then, bump! The covers roll right off the bed.
bed and everybody fell on the floor.
Oh dear, said Percy, this won't do at all. My bed is just too small.
Suddenly, one of mice pricked up his ears. What's that noise? He squeaked.
Everyone listened hard. Now they could all hear it. There was a scratching, scrapping sound. It seemed to come from the underneath them.
There's something moving under the floor, whispered Percy.
The animals looked frightened and the mice all stared to squeak at once.
Oh dear, what could it be? Morbid monster with fierce claws and sharp teeth.
The noise grew louder and louder. Then one of the floorboards began to move.
Look out, it's coming up through the floor.
Suddenly, there was a loud crack.
Help, cried the animals, and they all ran to hide.
But Percy wasn't frightened. He started to chuckle. Then he laughed loud. A small dark head was sticking out through the floorboards.
This is the monster, said Percy. It's a mole.
I'm sorry to burst in like this, said the mole. I knocked on the door, but nobody heard me. Percy helped the mole up through the hole in the floor, set him on his hot water bottle to get warm, and put the floorboard back.
It's all right, everyone, he called. You can come out now.
But no one moved. No one stirred. Nobody stirred. Nobody wanted to come out. The squirrel was tucked away in the pocket of Percy's dressing room. The hedgehog was in his coat. The fox, the rabbit, the badger, and the ducks were all safely hiding away. The mice had been squeezing themselves into Percy's slippers. Everyone had felt in cozy bed.
Well, I never, said Percy.
Percy yawned and snuggled down his own bed at once time.
That's better. Now I got plenty of room, he said, and a little to spare for a mole.
This is the end of this story. Now I'll show you the very big picture of Percy's hut. It's full of animals. That's all. Thank you for your listening.